one of the people who's played an odd but very important role in my life has been Richard Gregory, because I first met him in 1979 when my husband was desperately looking for a job in vision and came to visit Richard at his brain and perception laboratory in Bristol, and I came along. And it was the most extraordinary interview. This was an interview for a job, supposedly. And Richard says, oh, hello, you two. I'll come in here. Oh, I'll just have a cup of tea. Oh, look at this, look at this. And he's showing us all these amazing scientific instruments and asking us, what do you think about this? And isn't science fun? And I'm going, yeah, yeah. And wonderfully kind of encouraging and exciting, kind of maddening with enthusiasm, but really kind of inspiring attitude. Well, Tom got the job and we ended up living in Bristol. I was at home with the kids. As usual, I didn't have any money. I didn't have any job because I was studying the paranormal and no one wants to pay you to study the paranormal and so on. But what Richard did was he allowed me to be called a visiting research fellow, which didn't pay me any money, but it allowed me to use the computer. Yes, there was one computer in the university at that time, and have access to the library and to work in Tom's room when I could get away from the kids and go there. In fact, he allowed us to bring the babies in. He had this big cardboard box that some apparatus had arrived in, and we used to put the babies in the cardboard box, you know, while we were there working. And what was particularly interesting to me was that at that time I was not as totally skeptical about the paranormal as I later became. I was studying out-of-body experiences. Richard was extremely skeptical about all paranormal phenomena, and yet I think he appreciated that I was going to study these things, you know, that I was actually going to try and find out. And his support and his encouragement was very, very helpful, and I think in a way that enabled me to feel that I was part of a scientific community. Even though I had no job, even though I had no, you know, real status, I was able to get on with it. And that helped me for a long time.